Now, it used to have a strong reputation for press freedom, but now international monitors say independent reporting in Latvia's media is under serious threat. It's been prompted by a series of incidents involving raids on the homes of journalists who've been trying to investigate senior government officials. RT's Alexei Yereshevsky has the story.
With professional persistence, Latvian TV reporter Ilze Nagla interviews a local politician. In 20 years as a journalist, she has done hundreds, but one of them got her in serious trouble. An expose on a security breach in Latvia's state revenue body ended with police in her apartment.
With force, they opened the doors and went into my flat. And then they showed that they have a security search, they have a search warrant. Once they took my computer and information I got, they also acquired information on all other my information sources, which by law I'm allowed to protect. And that was the biggest problem for me as a journalist, because I could not protect my information sources.
Ilze's story shocked many in Latvia, a country not used to press scrutiny.
Just a couple of years ago, Latvia boasted one of the highest freedom of press ratings in all of Europe, being placed seventh on the annual Reporters Without Borders index. But for one reason or another, in 2010, this country is down on the very same list.
This incident is far from an isolated case, say experts. This one received a lot of public attention, but it is not the only one.
A scholar from the Ventspils High School and economist was charged by the secret police, and he was actually arrested for 2 days for disseminating alternative opinions about the future of the local currency. He said that devaluation of lat was imminent. We are losing the last support for the alternative information, liberal information among the press outlets in this country.
Lata Lapsa is another journalist who defiantly insists freedom of the press is not being deliberately strangled. He believes the reason is down to economics.
Most of our newspapers went bankrupt after the recession hit Latvia. Others turned to their owners for money to survive. So the owners started single-handedly shifting the paper's editorial policies to their own preference, simply for the sake of earning a healthy dollar. And that has directly hit press freedom.
There are other theories, however. Some believe that Latvia is spiraling down the freedom of the press ratings simply because the people behind the index are biased and Riga has fallen out of favor geopolitically. But Nagla believes that as long as nobody has been punished over the forceful search of her apartment, concerns about pressure on the press may not be groundless. Alexei Yereshevsky, RT, reporting from Riga in Latvia.